I remember the good old days when GPU launches used to be exciting. Well, not anymore because of miners and scalpers. These days, if anything, GPU launches are a little bit more annoying. Back in March, AMD launched their brand new Radeon RX 6700 XT, and since we couldn't make the original release date, we decided to wait a few months for the drivers to get a little bit more mature. And that's totally the reason, and not because we were actually waiting for you guys to give two shizz about benchmarks when the card becomes a little bit more available. Anyways, let's get cracking. Okay, before we dive into the review, I'm a little bit curious. Why don't you guys leave a comment down below to let us know what does an average RX 6700 XT actually cost in your country, in your currency converted to USD? Let's just hope that curiosity doesn't kill this cat because I'm more a dog person. So, the RX 6700 XT. This is actually quite an important launch because it's going to boast the slimmer cut down Navi 22 die that is 35% smaller than the Navi 21 die being used in the previous cards, the RX 6800, 6800 XT, and also the 6900 XT. This can hopefully help us navigate some of those issues surrounding the GPU shortage. It is targeted at 1440p gaming and aims to go head to head with the RTX 3070 from the green tea. Now, most of the observations that I made about the RX 6000 series graphics cards are still valid, so feel free to check out our previous review if you haven't already, link here. Without further ado, let's take a closer look. Wow, why did I instinctively go closer when I say closer look? Damn cringe, right? Firstly, let's talk about aesthetics. The Radeon RX 6700 XT follows in the footsteps of its older brothers in the 6000 series reference cards with similar race car aesthetics. The GPU shroud is again made with this very high quality die cast aluminum that is mostly silver with black accents and comes with this very nice sandblasted finish. However, this time it comes with two fans instead of three, with a design that's pretty eye-catching. I see you, AMD. On the sides, the shroud wraps around to frame an aluminum heatsink painted in black, with a red line on one side and an illuminated red Radeon logo. The backplate is again spectacularly rigid and looks like it's milled from the same solid piece of aluminum. In terms of dimensions, this card is 267mm long, 110mm wide, and 40mm deep, and it occupies two expansion slots. In terms of thermal design, the RX 6700 XT comes with the same 9-bladed fans with the letter R for Radeon printed on them. This time we have two instead of three. The vapor chamber cooler has been replaced with a plain old aluminum heatsink with heat pipes and a copper block. In terms of airflow, things remain pretty much the same. The fans draw in cool air into the heatsink and hot air is expelled via the two huge windows on the sides. There's also a 0 RPM fan mode that turns the fans off on lighter workloads to keep your noise down. Next, let's take a closer look at the specifications. So I'm totally not reading off the spec sheet right here. Looking at the specs, the biggest differentiator here is of course the Navi 22 die that is 35% smaller than Navi 21 at just 336mm square. This leads to the RX 6700 XT packing 33% less cores, L3 cache, TMUs, and ROPs compared to the RX 6800. It also comes with a downgraded memory subsystem that is 192 bit wide and has a lower bandwidth of 384GB per second compared to the 256-bit and also 448GB per second on the 6800 and also even the previous generation RX 5700 XT, and that's pretty interesting. This smaller bus also shrunk the 16GB of VRAM on the RX 6800 to 12GB on the RX 6700 XT, and I would argue that that's ample for 1440p gaming. Look, the RTX 3070 only comes with 8GB and is doing just fine. What is actually ticking people off is the fact that this card is priced at $480, only 17% cheaper than the RX 6800. It doesn't seem like such a good deal for me, but I guess we'll just find out more during the benchmark test later. If you're one of those people that are triggered, do know that the RX 6700 XT actually comes with a much higher clock speed, about 23% faster than the 6800. Even with 33% less cores, this should hopefully help reduce the gap performance gap between these two cards. Also, AMD states that this optimized on-die cache should give us up to 2.5 times the bandwidth of a 256-bit wide bus running 12 gigabits per second GDDR6 memory. So here are the specs to our test bench. We're actually changing our processor to the Ryzen 5 5950X later this year, so we're gonna hopefully update those numbers. But for now, we're using these specs. Now let's take a look at some numbers. Firstly, we have synthetic benchmarks, and in 3D Mark Times Spy, the 6700 XT is about 20% faster than the last gen 5700 XT, but about 28% slower than the RX 6800 and 16% slower than the RTX 3070. In Unigine superposition, while the green team still takes the lead here, the 6700 XT is about 36% faster than the last gen 5700 XT. Moving on to gaming benchmarks, in Doom Eternal, the RX 6700 XT pulls ahead about 6% over the 3070 in 1080p and about 12% in 1440p. So it's a win for Team Red. In Shadow of Tomb Raider with ray tracing off, the RX 6700 XT only matches the lower end RTX 3060 Ti, still about 9% slower than the RTX 3070. But you can see that it's about 30% faster than the 5700 XT. With ray tracing on, we're still getting over 60fps in 1440p. That is completely playable, but it's still lacking quite a bit behind the RTX 3070. Death Stranding is where the 6700 XT shines. It pulls up slightly ahead of the RTX 3070 in both 1080p and 1440p, and it's only less than 7% slower than the RX 6800. In Cyberpunk 2077, the green team seems to do a lot better, even without ray tracing. With ray tracing off at 1080p in ultra settings, the 3070 is about 20% faster than the 6700 XT. Even the 3060 Ti narrowly beats it. In 1440p, we're pretty much still seeing the same thing. We can't really test ray tracing here because it's not available on the Radeon card. But if you take into account DLSS, the gap is only gonna widen. It seems that Night City still prefers it green. Finally, we have real-world benchmarks. In Premiere Pro, CUDA is still king here, so really no surprises. After Effects shows that the new updates have made our After Effects benchmark obsolete, so moving on, we're gonna use the one from Puget Systems instead. In Blender Classroom, the 6700 XT is about 21% faster than the last gen 5700 XT, but still loses to the 6800 by about 23%. DaVinci Resolve shows that things are pretty close here. It really doesn't matter which if you're using any of the current gen cards from Team Red or Green. Finally, we put the card through the Fermat stress test for about 10 minutes. The reference design kept the card at completely acceptable temperatures, but it got a little bit toastier compared to the 6800, which had 3 fans, and that topped out at about 6 to 7 degrees cooler. So what's the verdict? Oof, this is going to be a tough one because we normally judge a card based on its price to performance ratio based on the MSRP, you know? Because ultimately it all comes down to the value proposition. Is this card worth your money? Regardless, since the MSRP is the only constant we have, I can only judge the card based on that. So here are the pros, mehs, and cons of the RX 6700 XT. So firstly, let's take a look at the pros. Number one is pretty well built, has more VRAM than you need, is great in 1440p gaming without ray tracing. In terms of rasterization performance, it is a lot more improved compared to the previous generation, and the ray tracing performance is acceptable. Next, the DaVinci Resolve performance is comparable to the green team. It comes with all the new tech with the Radeon 6000 series, such as HDMI 2.1, PCIe 4.0, and all the good stuff. So that's a little bit more future proof. It also runs pretty quiet with an excellent thermal design, and also the 7nm process lowers the TDP and ultimately also the total power draw. Moving on to the meh. And there's only one, is that if you're buying this card for productivity purposes, do know that OpenCL in Radeon is still not as widely utilized or optimized as CUDA, so yeah. Finally, we have the cons. Firstly, it's the price to performance ratio. Now, this card should be about $30 cheaper, which is about $50 cheaper than the RTX 3070 based on the performance comparison. Also, the ray tracing performance is still inferior and not as mature as the green team. And finally, Fidelity FX Super Resolution is still not here. So AMD, faster lah, release, I want to see. With all that being said, I give the Radeon RX 6700 XT an okay, cheap buy, 7.5 out of 10. In conclusion, it's pretty hard to form a decent conclusion on this card because of the GPU shortage. However, here's some good news for you guys. We just reached out to some of the authorized dealers here in Malaysia, and it seems like the stock availability for this card is improving. So that's good news. Yet, looking at the supposed SRP prices from partners here in Malaysia, I can safely say that you can be prepared to pay a lot more for this card if you're not from the US of A. I was actually a lot more impressed with the RX 6900 XT because of the better price to performance ratio as a flagship from AMD. Nonetheless, the RX 6700 XT is still a decent buy if number one, you game in 1440p but don't really care about ray tracing, since actually most games don't really benefit from ray tracing yet. And number two, if you work on any productivity applications that actually utilize AMD tech a little bit better, such as DaVinci Resolve that we demonstrated just now, go back to see if you haven't already. So there's that. If you thought this video is awesome, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and so hit the notification bell to see more content like this. And don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Instagram, TikTok to see more shenanigans from the Mob House crew. And I will see you in the next one after I read the comment section. Let's take a look at the YouTube of our Corsair compilation review that we did earlier. Asfar said, where to buy the mouse pad? Taobao lah bro. Muhammad Shami says he's chilling with his Keychron K8 and K1. Hello, your K8, K1 add together also don't have K65 bro. Raymond Lim, and not Raymond Yong, says that he loved our video and also is happy that a fellow Malaysian can be this good on YouTube. He wants to learn from the bangsawan himself, which is Lim Pei. Very good. Bro, I love you too. Chiao says that 8000Hz polling rate is good on the mouse, but not so much on the keyboard. I completely agree, which is my conclusion from the test. Moving on to Facebook. Michael Wee says, how does this compare to the Razer DeathAdder V2 or the Huntsman? I don't know, because it's been a while since I touched any Razer products because I was a bit disappointed last time with their Black Widow. Zachary Zachariah says, this one for champions. If keyboard warriors leh, use which one? Keyboard warriors cannot use this because keyboard warriors, the bark is louder than the bite. You know, they're very big thing. But when you ask them to, you know, takao, they're very scared, run away. So this one don't have the loud blue switch click 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 for them to click 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 every day. They can just annoy their own self in their own brain. Toby Chin say yes, he also want brown switch. Yeah lah, I already told them already. Muhammad Hidir asks, can I order custom PC with you guys? Cannot, like I said, I'm a bangsawan, bukan penjajah PC bro. And that's all for comments this time. Leave more comments. Now MCO, you got nothing better to do also. Then I can reply to you ma. And then if you ask stupid questions, I can also flame you a few times. Okay, I'll see you guys. Bye.